Good evening, public hearing.
Good evening and welcome to this press briefing. I'll request senior DEC Shubhi Sinha to begin the proceedings.
Very good evening. Very good evening to all media friends. We are here again for yet another round of media briefing. I welcome you all. We have now transited to the latter half of the electoral journey. With the completion of fourth phase of election almost over today, about 68% parliamentary constituencies have concluded the polls. The fourth phase constituted of 72 parliamentary constituencies in 9 states. This includes Anantnag parliamentary constituency of Jammu and Kashmir, which has 3 phased elections. The first phase of this parliamentary constituency consisted of all polling stations of Anantnag district and went to poll on April 23rd, 2019. The second phase had Kulgaon district, wherein polling took place today. The third and last phase of this PC will consist of Shopian and Pulwama district, which is due to for poll on May 6th, 2019. To give a holistic picture, by today polling has concluded in 373 parliamentary constituencies across the country. This includes 91 parliamentary constituencies in phase 1, 95 in phase 2, 116 in phase 3, and 71 parliamentary constituencies today in phase 4. This includes excludes Anantnag and 8 Vellore. If you may recall, polling in 8 Vellore parliamentary constituency of Tamil Nadu was rescinded by the commission. The dates for the same will be announced by the commission in the due course of time. A total of 22 states and union territories, excluding Vellore, had completed their polling by third phase, with the curtains coming down in the states of Maharashtra and Odisha today. The tally of states where the polling has been fully completed goes up to 24. The states which opened up to the polling today were Jharkhand, Madhya Pradesh and Rajasthan. Jharkhand and Madhya Pradesh go to polls in 4 phases beginning today. Rajasthan has polling in 2 phases, with 13 of its 25 parliamentary constituencies having gone to poll today, and the remaining 12 on May 6th, 2019. Besides these, the fourth phase encompassed Bihar, Jammu and Kashmir, Uttar Pradesh and West Bengal, each concluding their matching phases. Let's take a quick look at the electoral journey traversed so far. The voter turnout in phase 1 was 69.50%. It was 69.44% in phase 2 and 68.40% in phase 3. If we look at the absolute number of voters who had turned out to vote in the corresponding parliamentary constituencies in 2014 election, more than 4.96 crore voters came out to vote in the first 3 phases of the national elections in 2019. This sizable increase is due to the credit of our voters who placed the call of the country before anything and everything else. In terms of the voters turnout percentage also, putting the first 3 phases together, it's an increase of about 0.657% as compared to 2014 election. This national elections for the first 3 phases put together, compared to 2014, 6.79 crore more electors were on the roll. 79 crores. More electors were on the roll. The size of electorate for the fourth phase of the poll held today was 11.9 crores, of which women voters were 5.7 crores. A glance at the figures of our persons with disabilities give us another reason for being optimistic. The number of persons with disabilities electors was 1.7 lakh in phase 1, 8.52 lakh in phase 2, 9.98 lakhs in phase 3, and more than 10 lakhs today in phase 4 of the polls. The elections for the fourth phase today were completed from 1.46 lakh polling stations. As all of you are aware, the assembly elections were being held simultaneously with national elections in the four states of Andhra Pradesh, Odisha, Sikkim and Arunachal Pradesh. It is quite heartening to announce the completion of the polling for all the assembly polls today. Now some of the moments of gracias. The first and foremost, I would like to thank millions of voters who braved the scorching heat in order to come out and cast their vote. It's quite encouraging to see a large number of women, senior citizens and persons with disabilities queued at the polling stations to exercise their franchise. My gratitude to all polling officials, starting from booth level officers to the AROs, ROs, DOs and chief electoral officers and all state nodal officers. A lack of the security personnel from CPF, police force and other para police organizations, they are deployed at the polling station to enable a free and fair elections. We must all realize that the conducting elections on such a gigantic scale is an exercise that tests one's endurance in every way which possible. We are grateful to media, both print and electronic, for their continued support in increasing transparency of the Indian electoral process. For the subsequent phases, I implore the voters to come out and vote, braving whatever odds might exist, as they have done so far. On behalf of the Election Commission of India, I thank all stakeholders for their support to the electoral system. Thank you very much. For the states and the polling percentage and all details, now I'll be requesting my colleagues to present it. I'll request Mr. Sandeep Saxena to kindly. Yeah.
Very good evening to all of you. I will be beginning as usual with some of the highlights of electoral roll and the IT. I'm very happy to inform you that the Indian complete number of electorate now, which is going for poll, has been finally reached to 91,136,588. And this is what is the number in all the seven phases put together who will be going for poll. So I again repeat, 91,136,588. This does not include the service voter. So you will have to add another 18 lakhs to reach to the final electorate who would be taking part in the elections of 2019 parliament elections. Of this, 1.91 crore are the first time voters, 18 and 19 year voters. So 1.91 crores. And I'm happy to inform you that in last almost 1.5 months, there is 20% increase in the total number of 18 to 19 year whom we call the first time voters. We have also mapped 62.27 lakh number of persons with disability category of electors, and through the portal as well as through the app, 56% of them have given their requirement for facilitation to the Election Commission, which all our field staff has made the efforts to make it available. As far as the service voters is concerned, up to phase 5, total 14.68 lakh number of postal ballots one way electronically have been sent by the returning officers, and of that 11.63 lakh number have been downloaded to be given to the service voters. So that shows that with the alacrity with which the field staff is working to include the service voters in the entire fold. I am also happy to inform that National Voter Services Portal, NVSP, today 18.2 crore number of hits were made. This is unprecedented on a single day. This I am giving the figure up to 5 p.m. So if you see, this is the way the use is increasing, and 84 lakh number of people have verified using the toll-free SMS their particulars on the SMS gateway of the ECI 1950. Voter Helpline mobile app, which was launched during this election only, has been so far accessed 3.19 crore times. And the very important thing, this is a new thing which we started today, upload your selfie, and this will be seen by all of you also, is on the Voter Helpline app we have done. And today 12,000 number of electors have posted their own selfie. This is more to sort of involve everybody to come forward and share their moment of joy. Also, you can see now the list of contesting candidates on the Voter Helpline app, and also the profile. And not only that, you can straightway send it on the social media also. So you need not download, then you upload. You can straightway see it and then send it on social media. And you can have extended search for press release, current news, important instruction, form, publication, or statistical data on the Voter Helpline app. So as you know that this app was launched only in March 2019, and we are adding on all these things. So similarly, Voter Turnout app, I need not say now, nobody is asking us what is the voter turnout. By the time we say, you are telling that this is what is the turnout. And we have now added the option that if you want to share it with your near and dear, on the Voter Help, on the Voter Turnout app itself, you can send it to the social media. This new facility has been added. MCC violation portal, you can see what is the total status of action taken on the MCC violation. As on today, the figure is 466 number of violations which are put on this portal at various stage of disposal. Also, the MCC reference from the central ministry portal had been made live, and up to now 47 number of references have come from the central ministries. I am happy again about the C-Vigil. Total number of complaint on C-Vigil as on today, which have been filed, are 1,28,840, and out of this, 1,895 are found to be correct, that is 78%. We are now maintaining a hit rate of 78%, which is a very high rate. And under Samadhan, out of 14,38,361 number of cases, 14,16,924, that is 98% of the complaint have been disposed of. Similarly, on Suvidha, 1,86,289 number of permissions have been requested. Within the timeline of 24 hours, 1,47,422 were disposed of also. As I look after two of the states, the Jammu and Kashmir and Rajasthan, I would like to share the details. First, I take Rajasthan, which has gone in the first phase for Rajasthan. In 22 districts today, the poll took place, and 13 PCs have gone for poll. Total number of polling stations are 28,182. Total electorate all put together is 2,57,50,310. If you add to that the service voter 26,633 and also overseas elector 68, the electorate which went for poll today is 2,57,77,011. Total 108 male and 7 female, 115 number of persons they were in the fray. And when we come to Jammu and Kashmir, it is for the second phase of Anantnag PC, wherein Kulgam district alone, 4 assembly constituency went for poll today. Total number of male electors were 1.79 lakhs, female 1.64 lakhs, others 13. So total 3.44 lakh number of electors have taken part in today's election, and 1,265 number of ETPBS were issued. Now the turnout finally, which has been reported for the Jammu and Kashmir constituency of Kulgam four assembly constituency rather I should say, is 10.5% is the final turnout. And for the state of Rajasthan, so far we have received the turnout of 64.5%. This is 5 o'clock figure. You will be seeing how it is changing. You can see that also. I now switch over to Shri Sudeep Jain to give the details about. Yeah, 2014 Rajasthan it was 64.48, and for these, this is I am telling PC to PC, and for Jammu and Kashmir, for Kulgam district alone it was 36.34% for 2014. Over to Shri Sudeep Jain.
We'll come back.
Good evening, friends. Let me give you the details for the three states of Madhya Pradesh, Jharkhand and West Bengal, out of which, as Sinha sir had already told, the Madhya Pradesh and Jharkhand, the polls started today. In both these states, the polls will continue till the seventh phase, that is the four phases in which these are going for polls. Starting with Madhya Pradesh, today the election, the phase 4 of the elections and the phase 1 of Madhya Pradesh, where 6 PCs out of 29 PCs went for polls, were completely incident free. There was also a by-election today in 126 Chindwara. So apart from the 6 parliamentary constituencies in Madhya Pradesh, one AC also went for by-election. The total number of voters in the fourth phase which went for elections was 53,90,000 male voters, 51.55 lakh female voters, 178 third gender, that is total of 1.05 crore voters were there out of the total voters in the state of 5.18 crores. The service voters in this phase were 9,864. There were 108 candidates comprising 10 female candidates and 98 male candidates. 13,491 polling stations were covered in these PCs. In the state as a whole, there are 65,283 polling stations, but today 13,491 polling stations were there. Webcasting was done out of these in 2,510 polling stations. Now, some of the highlights of the work which has been done in the state in preparation for these polls, there were 2.61 lakh arms, licensed arms that have been deposited in Madhya Pradesh till now. 47,280 non-bailable warrants have been executed. Today there were 27 PWD manned polling stations. The polling stations where the entire team of polling officials were from the PWDs. 14,431 vehicles were deployed by volunteers to take the elderly, disabled, pregnant women and lactating mothers to the polling station. Then 359 polling stations were covered with a queueless voting app, the app which would provide that the voters can take their tokens in advance and accordingly come and be there in the polling station. They don't have to wait. There were 645 all women managed polling stations. The polling percentage today covering these 6 PCs was 65.77%. 65.77% for the Madhya Pradesh, these 6 PCs, 65.77%. The polling corresponding polling percentage in these 6 PCs in 2014 was 64.84%. And these are, as we have always been telling, these are the figures that have come in till 5 p.m. and these are likely to change. The polling percentage in the bipol at Chindwara was 65.15%.
Sir, how much?
65.15% in the bipol in Chindwara. Coming to Jharkhand, the election again in Jharkhand today in the three parliamentary constituencies out of the total 14 parliamentary constituencies had been incident free except for a couple of very minor incidents. In fact, now the entire focus of the teams there is to ensure that safely we bring back the entire polling parties. The total number of voters today, male voters 23.85 lakh, female voters 21.40 lakh, 11 third genders, total 45.26 lakh voters, against the total number of voters in the state, which is 2.23 crore. Today there were 9,213 service voters, 59 candidates comprising 2 female candidates and 57 male candidates. 6,072 polling stations were covered today. Polling percentage 63.39% as compared to 63.82% in 2014. So 2014, the final figures for these three PCs taken together was 63.82%, whereas the polling percentage till now has been 63.39% in Jharkhand. There was one incident at Chatra, polling station number 286, where the last voter at 3:50 in the afternoon, 3:50 p.m., damaged the ballot unit. He was arrested. However, the poll was to continue till 4 p.m. and there was no other voter which was there. Nobody came till 4 p.m. So the poll was concluded without any difficulty, since the control unit of the EVM as well as the VVPAT were completely intact. Coming to West Bengal, today was the fourth phase out of the 7 phase elections in West Bengal. 8 PCs went for poll today out of 42 PCs in West Bengal. 69.06 lakh male voters, 65.50 lakh female voters, 288 third gender, total 1.34 crore voters against 6.98 crore voters in the state of West Bengal. Out of this, 27,653 service voters were there today. Total 68 candidates were in fray, comprising 9 female candidates and 59 male candidates. Out of 78,799 polling stations in the state, in today's PCs, there were 15,277 polling stations. And amongst these, 2,400 were covered with webcasting. In Suvidha, total 69,012 applications have been received in the state of West Bengal till now, against which 63,454 have been disposed of on time. And the polling percentage today has been 76.44% till now, 76.44%. as compared to 83.38% final figure in 2014. There have been a couple of incidents which I would like to bring to your notice. One was in booth number 199, Barbani, in 40 Asansol parliamentary constituency. Today at around 9:15 a.m., BJP candidate Shri Babul Supriyo went to the booth and went inside the booth along with his security guards, complaining that his agent was not allowed to sit. When the CRPF ASI in charge there protested the entry of the security guards with the arms inside the booth, he pushed him physically and entered the booth along with his security guards. That's the report which has come. Then the police observer went there at 11 a.m. He personally visited the booth, inquired. It was known that the candidate forcefully entered and misbehaved with the security personnel. The general observer also visited at 11:30 a.m. All of them have given their reports. And a case has been registered against Mr. Babul Supriyo and others, as well as a case has been registered against unknown persons regarding the incident of breaking off the glass of Mr. Babul Supriyo's car. Another incident happened at 38 PC Bardhaman Purb in polling station number 210 to 214 in this school. The BJP candidate of 38 PC, Mr. PC Das, entered into Karna MM school premises with BJP flags. Some TMC supporters who were in queue objected, and one from them threw a stone on the front glass of vehicle carrying BJP candidate. A FIR has been registered on the complaint of the candidate, Mr. Das. Then in 13 Ranaghat PC, booth number 89 and bar 2 and 89 bar 3, a bomb has been allegedly hurled at around 350 meters distance from the booth, resulting in a simple injury of three persons there. The alleged bomber has been apprehended by the police along with his motorcycle. Polling was not affected, continued peacefully. At 42 Birbhum polling station, 284 by 259, at around 11 a.m., some 10 to 15 young boys with mobile phones entered the booth. The Jawan on duty instructed them to keep their mobiles away, the CAPF Jawan. These boys did not do that, started video recording of inner portion of polling booth. As the Jawan stopped them, these boys went away. However, few minutes later, 100 to 150 villagers came to the booth. The Jawans tried protecting the booth, tried stopping them. However, they started hurling stones, started pushing the doors, and damaged the polling station booth. The Jawan inside the booth went inside to protect the EVMs and the material. He opened fire with his firearm, fired one bullet on the roof. However, after this, the polling continued peacefully. Coming to the EVMs today, overall replacement has been far lower compared to the first three phases. The total replacement of BUs, ballot units, has been 0.44%. Replacement of control units, 0.46%. And replacement of VVPATs has been 1.91%. And out of these, 1.33% have been replaced because the VVPATs went into a non-operational mode. However, the balance were replaced because along with that, the ballot unit or control unit had to be replaced, and the protocol requires that we replace the VVPATs also. So I'll repeat, VVPATs that were actually non-operative had to be replaced was 1.33%, BUs 0.44% and CUs 0.46%. Thank you.
Thank you. Now, Mr. Chandra.
We'll circulate that to you.
Mr. Chandra Bhushan.
Yes. Thank you, sir. Good evening, friends. I'm going to talk about four states for which we have phase four elections today. Out of these four states, two states have completed their elections polling today. First one, Bihar. In Bihar, we had in five parliamentary constituencies, we have elections today. And 41,03,920. 41,03,920 इतने वोटर्स हमारे आज थे एंड 66 कैंडिडेट्स इन द फ्रे एंड 8,834 पोलिंग स्टेशन 8,834 मतदान केंद्र में 6 बजे शाम तक 58.92% की पोलिंग 58.92% का पिछले 2014 में ये नंबर जो है 56.18 था 56.18% इट मींस द पोलिंग परसेंटेज हैज गॉन अप दिस टाइम सो टेकिंग दिस टुगेदर वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द पोलिंग इन 19 पार्लियामेंट्री कंस्टिट्यूएंसीज इन बिहार टिल डेट महाराष्ट्र द सेकेंड स्टेट वेयर द पोलिंग वॉज completed for all 48 parliamentary constituencies today Today, it was in 17 parliamentary constituencies. 360 candidates were total in tray, and 3,05,874 इतने मतदाता आज इसमें शामिल थे. 3,05,874. Total number of polling stations 33,314. Voting का percentage जो 6 pm तक it was 58.23%. Which in comparison to 2014 when it was 55.58%. So we see a percentage increase also. We know that this today's phase was also around Mumbai and Thane area and all those things. So voting percentage has gone up during this particular phase. Then we have Odisha, where we had simultaneous elections. Today we had 6 parliamentary constituencies and 41 assembly constituencies were in elections, and 95,653 voters. 95,653 matdatas the parliamentary constituencies ke liye 52 उम्मीदवार और विधानसभा के लिए 336 उम्मीदवार आज मैदान में थे. कुल 10,792 पोलिंग स्टेशंस मतदान केंद्र पे आज मतदान हुआ. इसको लेकर के 21 जो वहां के टोटल जो लोकसभा क्षेत्र पार्लियामेंट्री कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसीज है वहां पे आज पोलिंग कंप्लीट हो गई. 146 विधानसभा में पोलिंग हुई है. एक में एडजॉइंट पोल है जो कि 19 तारीख को मई में शेड्यूल्ड है ऑलरेडी. कुल मतदान का प्रतिशत अभी तक 6 बजे तक जो है 68% आया है, जो कि पिछली बार 73.75% पोलिंग हुई थी.
This is for
Lok Sabha,
sir.
It's the same. So 68% polling till 6 pm 68% matdan 6 baje sham tak, aur pichli bar 2014 mein 73.75% 73.75% in 2014. उत्तर प्रदेश चौथा राज्य जो है यहाँ पर, उसमें आज 13 पार्लियामेंट्री कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसीज में इलेक्शन हुए, जिसमें कि 2,41,07,084 मतदाता आज इसमें शामिल थे. 2,41,07,084 वोटर्स नंबर. 152 कैंडिडेट्स, 152 उम्मीदवार इसमें शामिल हुए. 27,516 मतदान केंद्र, 27,516 पोलिंग स्टेशंस पे पोलिंग हुई, और टिल 6 पीएम द वोटिंग परसेंटेज वाज 57.58%, 57.58%, जो कि 2014 में ये 58.39% इन पोलिंग इन पार्लियामेंट्री कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसीज में था, 58.39% था. कुल मिलाकर के उत्तर प्रदेश में अभी तक 39 पार्लियामेंट्री कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसीज में इलेक्शन कंप्लीट हो चुका है, और जैसा कि आप जानते हैं बिहार और उत्तर प्रदेश दोनों जगहों में 7 फेजेस में मतदान होने वाला है. एक का घटना जो है जो आप लोगों के संज्ञान में मैं लाना चाहता हूँ वो ये है कि उड़ीसा में, जैसा कि आप लोगों को जानकारी होगी, फेनी साइक्लोन जो है उसके बारे में सूचना आई है कि आईएमडी फोरकास्ट जो फोरकास्ट है उसके हिसाब से कि 2 दिनों के बाद जो है फनी साइक्लोन की वहाँ पे लैंडिंग है. उसके हिसाब से कमीशन ने निर्देश दिए हैं चीफ इलेक्टोरल ऑफिसर को कि बाकायदा सभी जो हमारे स्ट्रॉन्ग रूम हैं जहाँ पे बाकायदा मशीनें रखी हुई है, इसके बारे में सभी पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज और उम्मीदवारों को बाकायदा इसके बारे में जानकारी दी जाए और जो भी उनके सुरक्षा के लिए जो भी कदम उठाए जाने हैं उसकी पूरी तरह से पहले से अनुमति ले ली जाए, उसका एक असेसमेंट करके और कमीशन से एक अप्रूवल लेकर ले लिया जाए तुरंत, और सारी कार्रवाई जो है वो सभी पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज के ध्यान में रखते हुए वो की जानी है, क्योंकि कई डिस्ट्रिक्ट जो हैं उड़ीसा के वो कोस्टल डिस्ट्रिक्ट हैं जहाँ पे इस साइक्लोन के लैंडिंग की सूचना है। उसके लिए उड़ीसा सीओ जो है वो अपने स्तर पे पूरी कार्रवाई कर रहे हैं सारे डिस्ट्रिक्ट इलेक्शन ऑफिसर के साथ मिलकर। थैंक यू
जस्ट वेलकम टू दैट मिस्टर दिलीप शर्मा।
थैंक यू सर, गुड इवनिंग एवरीबॉडी। फॉर एक्सपेंडिचर मॉनिटरिंग इन द फोर्थ फेज द कमीशन हैड डिप्लॉयड इन ऑल 97 एक्सपेंडिचर ऑब्जर्वर्स एंड टू कैरी आउट द इंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ द कमीशन द स्टेट हैड डिप्लॉयड एडिक्वेट नंबर ऑफ टीम्स flying squad, static surveillance teams and static surveillance teams and the video surveillance team and video viewing teams. I would like to share the deployment plan. There were 1761 flying squads, 1757 static surveillance teams, there were 1080 video surveillance teams and 618 video viewing teams. Apart from that, for monitoring the expenses of the candidate, there were 543 expenditure monitoring teams as well. As a result of the combined efforts of our enforcement team, the total seizure as on date stands at ₹3,274 crores. Now you have given the breakup. The total cash seizure is ₹785 crores. The total liquor seizure is worth ₹249 crores. Total drugs and narcotics seizure stands at ₹1,214 crores. Total precious metal, gold, jewelry and silver etc. Is worth ₹972 crores. And other freebies and other inducements given to the voters during these elections in the fourth phase up to the end of fourth phase stands at ₹53 crores. Thank you. Total seizure is ₹3,274 crores.
As good evening, everybody. As we did in previous phases of this election, communication division was active and prompt in responding to the issues, related issues. Paid use cases have been attended by the MCMC committees, and total paid use cases till this phase have reached to 581. Out of this, 136 in this phase only, 242 in first phase, 51 in second phase and 52 in third phase. Apart from this, one more information I would like to tell you regarding violations in social media. Social media platforms had complied to the voluntary code of ethics and have acted upon the directions of our nodal officers and Election Commission of India, and total till now 601 posts have been taken down by Facebook, 49 by Twitter, 5 by YouTube and 3 by WhatsApp, and share chat also 31 posts have been taken down. If you want, I can tell you regarding paid news. The maximum number of cases were reported in Andhra Pradesh, 286 cases till now. And Maharashtra, 150 cases. And apart from this, Telangana, 53 cases. This is state breakup. Chhattisgarh, 34 cases. And other states like Gujarat, 14. Jammu Kashmir, 20. Karnataka, 5. MP, 5. And Odisha, 2, and Rajasthan, 4. Tamil Nadu also reported 2 cases. UP and Uttarakhand, 3 each. Thank you very much.
You have
had a question.
Sir, the Congress candidate from Uttar Pradesh, from Dharora, Jitin Prasad, had put out a tweet earlier saying that he could vote but his sister could not vote because by the time she reached the polling station, her vote has already been cast. So, any information on that? Dharora, Jitin Prasad.
Yes. In fact, district election officer has looked into this matter already and his preliminary assessment was that some polling officer did it wrongly, they ticked that particular thing. But as you know that the law prescribes already a provision of tender vote related to these kind of situations. So law covers this particular area that if somebody has this kind of situation arises, then one has the opportunity to put the tender vote in this particular case.
Well, total turnout figure, last time it was 61.48%. Till now the figures which we have received is 64%. Yeah, last time figures for every state if you want, I think overall it was 61.48%.
Just for the country.
For the same
in 2014 it was 61.48 and for this particular poll so far reported is 64%.
Yeah.
So it is more than the last turnout.
Yeah,
only fourth phase the same number of PCs.
61.48.
Yeah, polling was peaceful. And only barring few cases, there were some issues which have been stated by the concerned DCs.
So, what are the model for violations? The Prime Minister and Rahul Gandhi still.
I would be requesting.
Sanjay Jha had tweeted about voting on the ink on his finger when he raised.
Congress. This is related to which state?
Maharashtra.
Yes. Yes. In fact, CEO Maharashtra has already been directed to submit a factual report in this particular matter. However, the preliminary input which he has given that again the interval ink which has been in use in that place was already CSIR lab certified. So, if this is some specific instance related to a particular polling booth, he will be submitting his report and accordingly whatever is required action that will be taken.
What about the PM?
Yes, regarding these complaints of violations of Model Code of Conduct against two political parties, senior leaders of two political parties, Commission has already taken all the input, all the details, and they have scheduled a meeting tomorrow morning for taking a decision on each of these issues. And the moment Commission takes the decision, we will be able to inform you maybe tomorrow or whatever time they.
Please clarify what.
Sorry. Yes,
please. Who are the
parties?
Just a minute. So, as per the information, whatever is available with us, there are three leaders which are there where the LE's complaints are there. One is Mr. Narendra Modi, another is Mr. Rahul Gandhi, another is Mr. Amit Shah. So these three leaders, the details have already been out, as I told you. There is a list of each of the least complaints. In each case, there are. I think that listing is not available with me. Which date and all those things. But as I told that tomorrow when commission is going to meet, I am going to take a call. on each of these issues, then you will be informed accordingly. So
that's is it coinciding with the tomorrow Supreme Court hearing, sir? Supreme Court, it seems.
I will not be able to comment on that particular issue because the 30th April, the schedule, this has already been fixed by the commission. So
when was the date fixed? Because this
Varghese
speech happened more than 3 weeks ago, so can you tell us like what
was the... If I told you that the listing of each of these incidents or whatever the alleged complaints are there, because it's not one or two alleged incidents, that then there are number of incidents. So all these are listed before the commission, and commission has already asked us to brief you that already a meeting has been scheduled for tomorrow and it is under consideration with the commission, so you will be informed accordingly tomorrow.
See, a few things I would like to make it very clear. See, all these things you should try to remember that a lot of diligence has to be done for this and all other cases, number one. Number two, today we had the fourth phase of election. Lot of things have to be done, and you should also know that MCC is not MCC per se. MCC includes the legal wing, which Mr. Chandbhushan is seeing, election expenditure, which is seen by Shri Dilip Sharma, media seen by Dhirendra Ojaji, and also planning and SDR seen by Umesh Sinhaji. So we have to take a very comprehensive view, number one. Number two, as already told by my colleague, that everything has been processed, and you know that every Tuesday commission has the commission meeting and has been told that it would be decided tomorrow. We will be putting before the commission the entire thing. So from the secretariat we have already processed everything and decision would be taken. Now the numbers etc. are something which whatever has come and is in final shape will be decided tomorrow. So I think we can wait for maybe a few more hours and we will be sharing immediately with you once the decision is taken.
Sir, just one question. So are you taking a consolidated view of all complaints or is it
No. Every violation, alleged violation I should say, would be taken separately, and whatever is the appropriate decision commission would be taking.
Sir, there are reports of violence in Jammu and Kashmir as
well as
stone pelting, those kind of things, clashes.
See, today it has not been reported. In fact, last two phases, I told last time also, while coming back, there was an accident in which some people became injured also. In some places, there was some stone pelting. For today's phase, I have not received any input so far. I would also like to tell you the consolidated thing which I missed. For Kulgam district today, including the migrant voter, the total turnout is 10.32%. And if you take Anantnag district as well as Kulgam both put together, for the parliament constituency, so far the turnout is 12.33%. As you know that 6 constituency in the, Anantnag, 4 constituency today, 10 constituency have already gone for poll, and for that total turnout is 12.33%.
आसनसोल में जो कैंडिडेट ने वायलेशन किया इन टर्म्स ऑफ टेकिंग आम सिक्योरिटी पर्सन इनसाइड, इनफैक्ट उनके साथ कुछ मीडिया पर्सन भी अंदर गए थे, उसके ऊपर उनके अगेंस्ट में FIR लॉन्च हुई है, एंड उनकी व्हीकल का जो डैमेज हुआ है उसमें FIR has been launched against unknown persons. The inquiry only would subsequently reveal as to who had done the damage. So that is the status on Assam.
And the allegation that he had made about this polling agent having been thrown out from there.
Nothing of that sort has come out. Both the observer, general observer, and police observer who had gone there, they had checked up. In fact, the candidate's polling agent came subsequently only. Candidate had reached at 9:15 a.m. and only subsequently after he had left, the candidate's agent had come and the polling continued and peacefully it went on in the polling station.
Maharashtra and Odisha finished polling today. Can we have the consolidated final turnout?
Yeah, I'll tell you. For Maharashtra, The first phase polling was 63.04%. Second phase, it was 62.86. Third phase, it was 56.25. And fourth phase, as has been told by Sri Chandrabhushan, it is 58.23. So all put together, as of now, it is 59.2%, but it will be increasing because last phase we have yet to get. Which other state do you want?
Odisha also finished.
Odisha first phase was 73.82, second phase 72.56, third phase 58.18, fourth phase 68%, and total becomes 68%, but it will be again changing. Okay.
So can we have the 2014 figures for these?
Yeah, 2014 figure, in fact, just now Sinaji has told for this phase, actually it is 63.05, please correct it, 63.05, not 61.48. I'm telling about this phase.
You're telling about all the phases?
No, I'm just telling, correcting the figure which we told for the fourth phase. Today it is 63.05, kindly correct that particular thing. Yes, for the entire phase 4 for 2014. Instead of 61.48, which was told by Sri Sinha, it is 63.05 2014. Odisha, I have already told the phase by figure. Total figure for Odisha is 73.8%.
For 2014,
all phases put together, it is 73.8%.
Yeah, I think.
And for Maharashtra, it is 60.3%.
You want to?
60.3%.
Just clarifying, you were saying the total turnout of these phases in 2014 was 63.05 and not 61.
Yes.
Mr. Chandrabhushan, that's for clarification.
Yes, please.
Today,
how many allegations against Mr. Narendra Modi, Amit Shah, and Rahul? See, the list, we have not come for that particular list, with that particular list, that X number or Y number against individuals. But tomorrow, once the decision is taken, then you will get a particular incident-wise, the decision of the commission will be communicated.
Thank you very much.
That's what I'm telling. That number you are saying, that which one, so that is not
available.
Thank you. Commission
had any take on the questioning of
decriminalization. Yeah, he's being responded.
So we had earlier also clarified, let me again clarify, the provision for asking a voter who complains of a wrong print in the VVPAT, the provision that he needs to file a declaration, and there is a penalty on that false declaration if it proves to be false, that is there primarily to prevent mischief, because every voter who claims a false vote or a wrong vote, the voting stops, he has to sign this declaration, he is given an opportunity to cast a test vote in the presence of presiding officer and all the polling agents, then this test vote has to be recorded in the form so that it is not taken for counting at the time of counting. So this entire process takes anywhere between 20 to 30 minutes. So to ensure that people do not do mischief by just trying to sabotage the process, if even 10 voters start coming in a polling station at different times and start making a false claim, if there is no penal provision, they will be encouraged to do that, and hence the entire polling process will be sabotaged. That's why the conduct of election rules under 49MA provides for this, and the false, if there is a declaration which is proved to be false there, then under IPC 177 for a false declaration, whatever is the penal provision, that applies.
So implicitly,
yes, IPC 177, the normal IPC clause in which there is an imprisonment and or fine which is provided for.
जैन साहब, पिछली बार भी समाजवादी पार्टी के जो मुखिया हैं उन्होंने ट्वीट किया और आज भी कन्नौज में यही कुछ हुआ, तो इसको लेकर इलेक्शन कमीशन कितना सीरियस है? आप कह रहे हैं ईवीएम को लेकर कंप्लेंट नहीं है, लेकिन पार्टियां लगातार कह रही हैं कि
when it comes to people who have claimed that a VVPAT has given a wrong print, to our knowledge there are only 3 cases which have been reported till date. 2 of those cases they actually went and given a declaration. One had happened during the assembly polls in Gujarat, one came up in Kerala. Both these voters were given the opportunity to cast a test vote and both were proved to be false. The only 3rd case where an ex-DGP in Assam claimed that he saw a wrong vote printed but refused to sign a declaration and hence did not go ahead with the test vote. Now that is only just a claim. However, the district authorities, the DO, went and got a detailed inquiry made, checked up with all the other voters who were around, found out that none of them made any complaint. All of them were fully satisfied with the process. So only one person claimed this and refused to go ahead with the legal process. So these are the only cases out of crores of voters who have actually seen their votes and have been fully satisfied with the print which came out in the VVPAT.
Sir, he was afraid of imprisonment. That's why he complained. We are also afraid of
ex-BGP.
Ex-BGP
saying that
he is afraid of.
Thanks a lot for your
complaint. Thank you.
Sir.